Ek was die laaste ouens wat 9 maande kamp gedoen het. 73 Julie in, Mei 74 uit. Die eerste kamp was op Vloaarklaaf. Die ander kampe was allemaal grens toe gewees, waar ek watervoorsiening gaan doen het, landmynopsporing en al sulke dergelike dinge. Ek het my laaste kamp gedoen in 78.
I was 17 years old. I became pregnant before I got married, and my dad didn't want us to get married. My dad said to me, no, we're going to get married for the sake of the child, and that he didn't want. And that's when your aunt left to go to Sishen. While I was pregnant, I finished my standard 8 and then I stopped going to school. And I had a little baby in May, Chantal. Then I moved down to Sishen to the Bing, where his parents was, because he had to finish his training at ISCO. And we arrived there about 2 weeks after the wedding, and everything was going fine until one day came home early. I said to him, what are you doing at home? So he says, no, he's got to go to the army. I said, but you didn't hear anything. So then he told me the story that the military police was at the work and they gave him 24 hours to get on the next train out of Sishen to the border, and he had to pack and get ready, and he was leaving the following morning on the train.
Before I went for my last scan, I did not feel happy with it. Want my oproeppapiere was laat. Die MP's het my by die werk kom soek en ek is nie 'n ou wat sulke kak aanjaag nie. As my papiere kry, dan gaan ek. Laat hulle my tot by die werk kom soek. Toe sê ek vir hulle, "Hey, boet, ek het nie eens oproeppapiere nie." Toe is my unit al op die grens. Heeltyd toe ek agterna gekom. Toe sê ek vir mamma, luister vir my baie ja mooi. As ek nie terugkom nie, gaan jy wel van my lees. Min het ek daai tyd geweet, dit gaan so uitdraai. Dit vroeg die oggend gebeur, want dit is maar wanneer jy aanval. Ek self was lekker stikkend geskiet. In my weg.
It was the 22nd of February, and then I arrived very late that evening by my parents and I went to bed. And then my sister came and called me and said my dad was looking for me. And I said, ah, tell daddy I'll speak to him tomorrow. I'm tired, I want to sleep. And then when I walked into my dad's room, there was this young policeman standing, and I knew then something had happened to Jan. Why would a policeman be that time of the night by my parents' house? And then my dad said, don't get too upset or don't get too emotional. Jan's just missing at the border, this is what this guy says. And then the policeman did say, he hasn't got much information for me, but Jan is missing on the border at the moment and I don't know where he is.
Alles is dood. Jy word gedra, jy het bloed wat loop. Is Februarie maand, dis reën, dis nat. En al wat jy het is hierdie klomp swapos rondom jou en hulle beweeg. Jy is so pas getroud, 'n mooi jong vroutjie, 'n mooi klein dogter. Die baby is 7 maande oud. Hier gaan haar pa, geen mens weet of hy ooit weer die son môre gaan sien opkom nie. Daar so by die huis sit 'n vrou waarvoor ek baie lief is, en 'n dogtertjie waarvoor ek bitter lief is, en hier gaan jy, wat nou?
right smart. From the Sunday Times, he contacted me and said, my husband's been captured. I was still young, stupid, young, inexperienced. My dad kept trying to sort things out, kept writing letters to the ministers to try and find out what's going on. The mayor of Brakpan's lady at that time that said to me my husband was a traitor. He had gone over the border, which I knew they were wrong, because he was a South African through and through.
Cadeia de São Paulo, São Paulo gevangenis. Eerste keer in my lewe wat ek in 'n tronk kom. I was prison for 4.5 years. Kijk, as van Luanda af, as ek in 'n aeroplane ingesit, off to East Germany. Nobody told me where you're going, what we're doing. So I said, well, there's three reasons, there's three reasons. Of ek gaan huis toe, of hulle gaan my execute, of ek gaan, hulle gaan my gebruik vir political propaganda. Ek, Suid-Afrikaner, enigste een. Hulle het 'n Rus, majoor Alexei Kozlov. Klim ek in 'n Mercedes in, vat my op so 'n bergpas, bo. Die ou wat my met die Mercedes ingeryd tot daarso, hy maak die deur oop, hy sê vir my, nou is jy 'n vry man, gaan op, daar staan jou mense en wag vir jou. Ek sê, hey, trots, nou gaan ek huis toe. Maar jy is nog nie by die huis nie. Jy moet eers loop tot daar by die helikopter, daar's ander wat daar gaan afklim. Dus loop tot by die helikopter, hier kom die ou afgestap. Skitsaad, ek sê, maak jou aan van 'n mist, hy sê, hom, Major Alexei Kozlov, ek sê, Sjap, jy gaan soutmyne toe, ek gaan mielielande toe. Moet uit, so dit maak die saak nie. Materiaal maak die saak hoe seer het is, die uit moet het uit. Dit is nou maar so. Al dit bietjie tyd vat.